Outside Parliament, they were demanding Brexit now, but they're likely to be frustrated because Britain's divorce from the EU will probably be a slow and complicated affair.
Order.
Inside, we did hear from the minister responsible for making Brexit work. He said there's no turning back.
And the Prime Minister's made clear there'll be no attempt to stay in the EU by the back door. No attempt to delay, frustrate or thwart the will of the British people. No attempt to engineer a second referendum. Because some people didn't like the first answer.
But the new government has been vague on details. Perhaps members who wanted Britain to stay in Europe argue because it simply doesn't know its own priorities or what deal it can realistically reach with the EU.
No one expects him to have worked out all of the answers yet, but we do expect him to be able to set out the outline of some kind of plan. And today we have heard nothing on that.
Meanwhile, at the G20 in China, Theresa May was trying to convince world leaders that Britain remains open for business, whilst also sending a message to voters at home that the free movement of people from the EU will no longer be tolerated.
What we will now have an ability to do, of course, which we haven't had before, is when we come out of the EU, we will be able to have some control on movement of people coming from the EU into the UK, which, of course, was the one element over which we weren't able to have control before.
Supporters of Brexit say that the economic consequences of voting to leave have not been nearly as severe as many had warned. Their opponents say we won't know the real cost until Britain actually starts to leave the EU. And when will that be? Well, Theresa May says that she won't initiate the formal two-year withdrawal process until 2017. Barnaby Phillips, Al Jazeera, Westminster in central London.